Hello students, now we are going to learn about what is a programming language, what is its need and why we use it. See, you have seen many softwares that we are using in our daily life for making our life easier than before. So many things are being automated, like you use microwave oven at your home, washing machine, refrigerator, AC. All of these are now smart. We call them smart or digital washing machine, digital refrigerator, digital or smart microwave oven, smart AC, etc. So what is that thing which makes them smart? Actually, this is the actual programming which has been done behind it to make them smart. That is to make them automatic, to automatic turn on and automatic turn off at a particular temperature, or when for ACs and for microwave ovens it is about at automatic temperature, and similarly for fridge also, and in case of machine at automatic it gets off automatically at a particular time. So sensors are actually used to make them work, and in sensors a lot of programming or code has been embedded into that. Now we are going to learn about what is a programming language. The computer understands only zeros and ones. That is called machine language. Computer understands only one kind of language, that is called machine language. And in earlier times when computer was developed, then only machine language was used. So any code or any name, suppose if somebody's name is Amit, then it is written or input in the system in the form of 0 and 1s only. Suppose these are the strings of code. The code can be only in the form of 1s and 0s. See, this is very difficult to remember for the programmer, that how to write ones and zeros and what has been written. And even if I wish to add two numbers, suppose 3 plus 5, then binary code of 3 and 5 will be added to get the result. The binary of 3 is, what is that? 0010. The binary code of 3 and 5 will be used to make them add. Fine. So the machine language was very difficult to understand, and to overcome that, assembly language came into existence. It was a bit easier than machine language. The code was not only in the form of zeros and ones, but mnemonics. Actually, it starts from M, where M is silent. Mnemonics were used in assembly language. Let's suppose add A, comma B. Okay, where A and B are variables, and add is the operation to be performed on A and B. Fine. And for subtraction, it was like subtract A comma B, then for multiply, mul A comma B, then for division, A comma B. Or we have to supply directly constant values for A and B, not the variable values. But still it was difficult to write this language, because we have to deal with the hardware by ourselves. Like in today's programming languages, we do not care about the hardware programming and hardware code. It is done by the programming language itself, by their compilers or interpreters. But earlier, for loading something, we have to write the loading instruction, like loading something to the accumulator, which is a part of the CPU, LDA, that is load to accumulator A. That means the value of A will be loaded into the accumulator like this, and we also need to provide the location as well where to save the value. So this was all about the assembly language. And after the assembly language, because it was also difficult to understand high level languages, came into existence. The machine language is called low level language. Machine language is called low level language. Assembly language is called middle level language. And high level languages are like C, C++, Java, Python, etc. and many more like ASP.NET, Perl, PHP. These are very high level languages because they came with IntelliSense. Numerous classes and objects associated with them can be referred very easily. And these are high level languages like C, C++, Java and Python. Python also came into very high level because it includes so many libraries to use for, which are used for various purposes. So high level languages are having statements, are having English language like statements or instructions. Basically, we provide instructions to the computer through programming languages to perform certain tasks. Suppose I wish to compute multiplication table of 2. Now, the multiplication of 2, multiplication table of 2 is quite easy. But the logic that we'll use for the table of 2 will be applied on 289 also. That is why computers or softwares are used which makes the task very simple. For example, if I compute the multiplication of 2, which is 2, 4, 8, 10, 12, and so on, the similar way, the similar logic will be applied to the multiplication of 289. But if we use machine language, it will be very difficult to compute. By assembly language, it will be still difficult. But by using high-level languages like C, C++, Java, and Python, it will be very easy to develop logic to compute multiplication of 2 or any kind of such problems. Because they are having statements like English. Even in C, the syntaxes of various kinds of building constructs of a language are very difficult. Like for printf, we have to write a long statement. For scanf, we have to write a long statement. But in case of Python, you just need to write print and in the bracket you give the variable name or the string name, then its value will be printed. We will learn all these concepts gradually in this class, in our course throughout this semester. Now, I will discuss a little about the history of Python. Python is a very powerful high-level language. It is also object-oriented programming language, developed by Guido van Rossum during 1985 to 1990 at National Research Institute for Mathematics and Computer Science in Netherlands. Actually, it was developed in this period from 1985 to 1990, but it was launched in 91. Guido van Rossum published the first version of Python code in February 1991, and gradually he released other versions also. The first version was 0.9.0 and gradually he has released many versions of Python, and recently the Python version 3.8.5 is being used, and in our class of Python we will use the same version of Python, that is 3, which is the latest one. Okay, you just need to remember the year and the developer name of Python, that is Guido van Rossum, and it is having general public license. That means it is an open source programming language which is free to use by everyone. That means anyone can use it if he or she wants to. Fine. And now, origin of Python means why it is named as Python. At the time when he began, that means Guido van Rossum, when he began implementing Python, Guido van Rossum was reading the published scripts from Monty Python, and he was very much influenced by Monty Python. That's why he named Python language as Python by the name Monty Python. It occurred to him that he needed a name that should be short, unique, and slightly mysterious. So he decided to call the language Python. Features of Python. There are numerous features of Python associated with it. It's a beginner's language. As I told you earlier, it's a very simple language. Anyone can learn this language very easily. It is easier than C, C++, and Java. So this is called beginner's language. Python is a great language for beginner level programmers, which supports the development of a wide range of applications from simple text processing to web browsers to games. You can develop simple programs to games, web browsers, etc. Easy to learn. Python has simple structure, a few keywords, and clearly defined syntax. I'll tell you, its syntaxes are very much simpler as compared to C and C++. Now, easy to read. It is clearly defined language, that is, a non-programmer understands it very easily. Easy to maintain. The source code of Python language is quite easy to maintain. Now, interpreted. It is interpreter-based language. That means, for some languages, we use compiler. For C, C++, we use compiler. But for Python, we use interpreter. These are the translators. Interpreter or compiler are actually the translators which convert machine-level language, which converts high-level language like C, C++, or Python into machine code. I already told you that computer understands only machine code. Therefore, we need to convert high-level language, that is in the form of English-like statements, into machine code. And that is done either by compiler or interpreter. And in case of Python, interpreter is used. The programmer does not need to compile the code before executing the program. Similar to Perl and PHP, Python has a built-in debugging feature. Interactive. Python programs can be directly written to the Python prompt by which user directly interacts with the interpreter. Python is interactive also, and you can also perform scripting using Python. I'll tell you both of the methods. Now, object-oriented. I hope you have learned about C++, that is OOPS. So Python also supports object-oriented concept. All the concepts of object-oriented programming paradigm or structure. Versatile. Python modules are capable to work with multiple operating systems and user interfaces, including images and sounds. Next is broad standard library. Python language's bulk library is portable and cross-platform compatible with Unix, Windows, and Macintosh. That means Python can be used. We can develop various kinds of software using Python in Unix, Windows, and Mac systems. Interactive mode. Python language has support for interactive mode, which allows interactive testing and debugging of code. Portable. Python language can be executed on a wide variety of hardware platforms and has similar interface on all the platforms. I already told you it can be implemented on Unix, Linux, Windows, Macintosh. So it is a portable language. Portable means the program written in Windows can be executed in Unix or Mac. Databases. Python language provides the facility of interfaces to all major commercial databases. That means you will learn database in your current semester or later on. Database means where the complete website data is stored. So Python has the compatibility with MySQL, MS SQL, Oracle, etc. GUI programming. Python provides graphical user interface applications that can be created and ported to many system calls, libraries, and window systems such as MFC, Mac, and the X window system of Unix. You will understand it gradually when you learn Python. Now, scalable. It provides a better structure and support for large programs. So, it is scalable. That means you can develop small as well as large programs using Python. There are a few limitations of Python also, which are negligible. Even then, I'll tell you about them. The first is, Python is interpreter-based language. Therefore, it is a bit slower than compiler-based language. Interpreter means, when we write code, then it converts it into machine language line by line. So, converting the entire chunk of code rather than converting single line, it takes a little more time as compared to compiler-based languages. Since Python is a high-level language like C, C++, Java, it also uses many layers to communicate with the operating system and the computer hardware. I already told you that computer understands only machine language, which is directly understandable to the computer. But high-level languages like C, C++, Java, Python, Perl, PHP, etc., they need a translator, either interpreter or compiler, to convert high-level language into machine language. So, there are many layers for this conversion. That's why they are a bit slower than the machine language. That is but obvious. Graphics intensive applications such as games make the program to run slower. That is true. The games developed by any language run slower if the system configuration is low. For that you need more RAM, more hard disk to run games properly. Now, major applications of Python. The list of companies that use Python include the following. Yahoo. It uses it for Yahoo Maps, Google, for its spider and search engine, and Linux Weekly News, published by using a web application written in Python, and Industrial Light and Magic, used in production of special effects for movies such as The Phantom Menace and The Mummy Returns. It is also used for graphics designing in many Hollywood movies. Apart from that, it has numerous applications, I tell you, where it is used. Let me show you. Who uses Python today? Python is being applied in real revenue generating products by real companies. For instance, real means which are really use it in today's world. Google makes intensive use of Python in its web search system and employs Python's creator. I already told you in the previous slide also. It uses Python for search engine and it's Python's creator version. Intel, Cisco, Hewlett Packard, Seagate, Qualcomm, IBM use Python for hardware testing. See, these are very prominent companies nowadays. Intel, whose processor we use in our laptops, Cisco, Hewlett Packard, Seagate, Qualcomm, IBM. They all use Python for hardware testing. ESRI uses Python as an end user customization tool for its popular GIS mapping products. Fine. And the YouTube video sharing service is largely written in Python. See, we normally share YouTube videos and its code is written in Python. Now, what can I do with Python? We can do system programming, we can develop graphical user interface, we can do internet scripting, like JavaScript, we can also use Python script. We can perform component integration, that means different softwares can be combined or can be made to work together using component integration. Then database programming can be done with Python, and gaming, images, XML, robot, etc. can also be developed using Python. So So these are the major applications of Python, and all the major companies use Python nowadays. And you should know that Python is the number one language and the highest paid programming language nowadays. So once you master this language, you can get a very good job with high package. Okay, now we'll continue further. Getting Python. In this course, I'll tell you to develop Python on the online tools available. Various tools are available online also for implementing Python. We will do our lab work on those tools. But if you want to work on your systems as well in offline mode, then I'll tell you the procedure. First, you need to download Python from the site www.python.org. This is the official site of Python. You can download Python from here. Then installing Python. For different systems, there are different steps. First, you need to install, need to download according to your requirement. If you are having Unix operating system or Linux operating system, then you will download the Unix Linux version. If you are working on Windows, then you will download Windows version. And if you are having Apple, then you have to download Mac version. Okay. Now I'll tell you how to do it. First of all, we'll open site. It is already opened. I have opened it for you, but I will open it again. We'll write python.org, then enter. This is the official site of Python. Here you will get all the documentation, downloads, etc. from here. I will click on downloads. See, the latest version is being shown over here. Download the latest version for Windows. If I click here, the latest version will be downloaded. And if you want to download for Linux, I will click here. If for Mac, I'll click here. And for others, you can click here. Okay. So you will click here and the Python will be downloaded on your system. And after it will be downloaded, then double click on it and then install it and follow all the steps as mentioned in it. All the settings will be done by it automatically. Okay, so this is the installation procedure of Python. There is an environment variable also. It will be set automatically by itself. If it doesn't get set, so these are the steps to set it. I will recommend you a book in which all the steps are clearly mentioned that how to set the environment variable. Otherwise, it will be set by itself when you install it. And then running Python. I will tell you this part when we'll execute it on shell or through prompt. There are three ways how to execute Python: interactive interpreter, script from command line, and integrated development environment. There are three ways. I will tell you all of them in detail in the next lecture. I hope you understand this lecture. If you will have any doubt or anything, then you can comment underneath this video or you can ask me. Okay, thank you.